including Wildfire himself, Tommy Rich. Plus, we'll be seeing the Central States heavyweight champion, Buzz the Avalanche Tyler, in action. And a very, very special match that we've been looking forward to since last week, as Ron Ritchie and the dynamic Ted Oates team up. They'll be taking on the devastating combination of the Grapplers. All this and many, many more exciting stars, plus some very important news concerning wrestling in your area, all upcoming in the next 60 minutes, right here on All-Star Wrestling. You make your plans to stay with us. Right now, let's go to the ring for ring announcer Terry Garvin and our first match of All-Star Wrestling.
This event is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Your referee, Sonny Myers. Introducing from San Antonio, Texas, weighing 223 pounds, Dusty Wolfe. His opponent from Portland, Oregon, weighing 241 pounds, Scott Ferris.
Dusty Wolfe and Scott Ferris, our first event here today on All-Star Wrestling. And if you're looking forward to 60 minutes of action and excitement, you're certainly not going to be disappointed today. Wait a minute! Dusty Wolfe starts this match off against the veteran Scott Ferris in high style, ducking that forearm. And I think Mr. Ferris may realize why Dusty Wolfe is one of the prime candidates for NWA Rookie of the Year, along with top stars like Tommy Rogers and many other young men who are making their presence felt here in the Central States area. Ferris, full scoop, hard slam on Dusty Wolfe that this got this young man from San Antonio, Texas, rather shaken up in the ring. We're excited about the next 60 minutes and about the situation here in the Central States in general. Of course, you know, we've been saying week after week that the competition is heating up. All of the top stars in the nation are making their presence felt here in and around the Central States. Of course, we're talking about Wildfire Tommy Rich, who we'll be seeing a little bit later this hour. Many, many of the top names in pro wrestling, including men from various other points of wrestling in and around the wrestling world, including the American Wrestling Alliance. Already they've made their presence felt in some towns, including St. Louis, Missouri. We've had an opportunity to take a look at guys like Blackjack Lanza, Blackjack Mulligan, the sensational Greg Gagne, of course, the son of legendary superstar Vern Gagne. And as the weeks go on, I'm sure that we'll be seeing these men and seeing just exactly what kind of competition they have to offer in the Central States area. Scott Ferris now. Oh, good drop kick from Scott Ferris. And that's the thing about this young man. He can brawl with the best of them, and apparently that's the way he's chosen for his career to go. But deep down inside, Scott Ferris does have a tremendous amount of natural wrestling ability. A little bit later this hour, we'll be taking a look at one of the most popular young wrestlers on the circuit right now. Of course, we're talking about Tiger Mask. And everywhere I go, from Topeka, Kansas, all the way to Columbia, Missouri, down to Sedalia, up to Des Moines, and even across to the great city of St. Louis, fans all over are talking about Tiger Mask and some of the tremendous wins that he's had in the last couple of weeks. Many of them right here on All-Star Wrestling. Scott Ferris with that deep double arm suplex on Dusty Wolfe. Not quite enough to put this young man away. Dusty Wolfe has got a lot of grit. Here's a young man who's been in this sport maybe anywhere from 6 to 8 months, but he wrestles with the confidence of a young man who's been in the sport maybe 2, 3, maybe even 4 years. A tremendous young man. And oh, look at this! Dusty Wolfe with what can only be politely called a reverse atomic drop on Scott Ferris. And Dusty Wolfe, obviously tired of some of the tactics that he's seen from this man, gets set, gets ready to go to town. They lock up collar and elbow, and Dusty Wolfe is all over Scott Ferris. Ferris now into those far ropes, caught with a shoulder smash. And Dusty Wolfe showing some of the fire that's made him one of the top competitors in the relatively short time he's been in our area. Ferris, a very unique maneuver. It looked like he was going for a backdrop, but instead a football-like tackle into the midsection of top. Oh, look at this. Wait a minute. Oh, what strength. Dusty Wolfe looked like he was trying, for a cross body block, found himself caught. Reverse pile driver from Scott Ferris. And in very short order, we see a win for one of the rising stars in the Central States area, Scott Ferris. Now, still to come in the next 60 minutes, we'll be seeing the Central States champion Buzz the Avalanche Totter, plus a very special challenge tag when Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates take on the Grapplers. That's still to come this hour here on All Star Wrestling. And the music you hear in the background, she works hard for the money, can only mean one thing. The Central States heavyweight wrestling champion's on his way to the ring. And here he comes, Buzz, the Avalanche Tyler, here for our second event on All-Star Wrestling.
Introducing from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 282 pounds, the Central States champion, Buzz Avalanche Tyler.
Buzz the Avalanche Tyler getting set to take on T.G. Stone in this non-title match here on TV. T.G. Stone, right off the bat, attacking Buzz the Avalanche Tyler from behind, nails the Central States champion several hard shots, whips Tyler into, oh, big knee lift from Buzz Tyler, cross body block, and only a count of two. There's some bad blood between these two. Not too very long ago, I saw T.G. Stone go to a very short time limit draw with Buzz the Avalanche Tyler in a non-title match. That set the stage for this return bout here on television. And Buzz Tyler certainly has got a lot on the line. T.G. Stone, he's had a lot to say about himself, but by and large in the ring, Mr. Stone has been able to back up 9/10 of what he says. Caught coming in by Buzz Tyler with that hard elbow. Tyler's a fighter. And one look at the Avalanche, and you know, here's a guy that's been through some back alley brawls and seen more of his share of trouble in the wrestling wars. Still to come this hour on All-Star Wrestling, we'll be taking a look at the legendary Bulldog Bob Brown. Plus, we'll have a chance to see in action Wildfire Tommy Rich, who's on his way to the Central States area. T.G. Stone now moving in on Buzz Tyler, hammering in those hard elbow shots to the back of the neck of Tyler. And Stone, I think, somewhere in the back of his mind, realizes what a win on Buzz Tyler would be, especially here on TV. Tyler must know it, too, because he's coming back for all he's worth. A couple of hard right hands. And T.G. Stone finds himself just inches away from defeat at the hands of the Avalanche. We got to give a lot of credit to NWA promoter Bob Geigel. Of course, as all wrestling fans know, the Central States Tag Team Championship belts are held up. At the end of March, there will be a one-night round-robin tournament to decide who will be the Central States Heavyweight Wrestling Tag Team Champions. Applications are coming in from all over the country. Hopefully, a little bit later this hour, we'll clue you in on some of the top stars that'll be making their presence felt. I know one team, of course, the team of the masked grapplers, who've definitely got their bid in. Buzz Tyler now fighting his way from the floor after absorbing a tremendous amount of punishment from T.G. Stone. Tyler, another boot to the midsection of the native of Nome, Alaska. And I think T.G. Stone may be thinking twice about some of the tactics he's used on the Avalanche. Knee to the midsection, lateral press, and again, Tyler gets away with a count of two. T.G. Stone following up his advantage. What a reputation this man had. Wait a minute. Stone hits his man. He may be trying for the Alaskan anchor. He may be trying for that front suplex. Tyler's got a small package. One, two, three. We got a win on TV. T.G. Stone looked like he was going for that Alaskan anchor. Buzz Tyler got him by surprise. And a big, big win for the Central States Heavyweight Champion, Buzz Tyler. still to come. We'll get a look at Tiger Mask. We'll see Wildfire, Tommy Rich, Crazy Luke Graham, Bulldog Bob Brown, and many more. You stick with us. There's a lot of action yet to come when All-Star Wrestling returns right after this very important message.
The gateway to professional wrestling, that's St. Louis. And in the Kiel Auditorium on Friday, March 30th, 7:30 p.m., you'll see 25 wrestlers go in some of the most exciting matches that you have ever, ever seen, including the Missouri title with no disqualification. Your tickets on sale right now. Kiel Box Office, All Famous Bar Stores, Regal Sports, Team Togs and Tickets, or dial Tix at 644-1700. You can mail order, too, to St. Louis Wrestling Club, Kiel Auditorium, 14th and Market Street, St. Louis, Missouri. There is no service charge. Or dial 436-4400. Now let's look at this card. What a card. Missouri title between Harley Race, who is managed by Bobby Heenan, and Wahoo McDaniel. A six-man tag team match against Blackjack Mulligan, Blackjack Lanza, Bruce Reed, and they go against Crusher Blackwell, Ken Patera, and Luke Graham. What a match. And then Jim Garvin with Precious and Chris Adams. There's Hacksaw Dugan, a one-man gang. Dick the Bruiser's going to be there against Cy Jurgensen. Dick Slater, Buzz Tyler, Steve Kern, and Steve Stan Lane go against Don White and T.G. Stone. Then you'll find Ted Oates and Les Thornton against the Grapplers. Ted, the Grapplers are following you all over the state.
It looks like it. You know something, the Grapplers, they've been very successful in St. Louis. St. Louis is the mecca, the gateway of professional wrestling. Everybody wants to be there and make their mark. Well, Grapplers, let me tell you something. I've got a partner, Les Thornton, the world's junior heavyweight wrestling champion. He's wrestled all over the world. I've wrestled all over the world. I've wrestled him a lot of times. He's beat me. I've beat him. We've had a lot of draws. He's from England. He knows everything to do. I know everything to do. And Grapplers, I just have a sneaking feeling in St. Louis, your winning streak is coming to an end.
St. Louis, this is your chance to see some of the most exciting wrestling ever. All-Star Wrestling. Call 436-4400 and get your tickets now.
World-class championship wrestling Sunday morning at 10, right here on Channel 30.
This event is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing from Winnipeg, Canada, weighing 233 pounds, Ron Ritchie. His partner from Columbus, Georgia, weighing 227 pounds, Ted Oates. Their opponents with a combined weight of 496 pounds, the Grapplers.
Here we have it, the match you've been waiting for. Ted Oates and Ron Ritchie together in tag team action against one of the most controversial teams to come down the pike in a long time, the Masked Grapplers. And hey, I don't think Ritchie could have found a better partner than Ted Oates. We've seen Ron Ritchie the last couple of weeks really develop that spinning toehold. And I had a chance in St. Louis not too long ago to talk to the former world champion, Dory Funk Jr., who had, by the way, been working with Ron Ritchie in the gym on this maneuver. And it just so happens that the spinning toehold is also the favorite move of Ted Oates. So here we see two young guys with a world of experience between them and many, many similarities in their ring style against one of the premier teams and possibly the greatest mass team in the history of the sport, the Grapplers. Tag from Ted Oates. Ritchie's up on that second rope. Ritchie! Big splash on the arm of Grappler number two. And it looks like Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates have spent some time putting together a little bit of strategy to upend these Grapplers. And of course, with that big tournament for the tag team championships coming up, everyone in tag team competition is looking to eliminate as many people as possible to assure them of a top slot in that tournament. Ritchie now up and over his man. Ritchie looked like he tried the boot. The Grappler brings his man up for the atomic drop, blocked by Ritchie. Ritchie, standing switch, atomic drop on the Grappler that sends him over the top and onto the floor of the television sports arena. And the Grappler number two, now in obvious pain, slowly making his way back into the ring. what a combination we've got in Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates. Wait a minute. Some of the fans at ringside are shouting that there's been a switch between the grapplers. I couldn't see it from my vantage point. But there are some highly irate fans at ringside claiming that the grapplers have switched, and it looks like yes, referee Sonny Myers have ordered them to turn around and make a legal tag. That brings the grappler number one in against Ron Ritchie. And I'm thinking back several weeks ago, right here on All-Star Wrestling, when we saw Ron Ritchie catch that boot in the back of the head and leave him stunned and unconscious on the canvas. The tag to Ted Oates. And Oates, right on his man, comes in with that side headlock. And here's a man from Columbus, Georgia, that's really made his mark in tag team wrestling. There's the very few men who know as much about tag team wrestling as Ted Oates. Hard shoulder tackle that sends the grappler to the canvas. Oates caught coming off those ropes with a full body slam. The grappler's back. He comes down with that knee, but Oates was gone. Oates, two swift kicks to the kneecap and behind the leg of the grappler. And Ted Oates moves into that spinning toe hold on the grappler number two. Grappler managing to kick out. The other grappler comes in. And here's Oates right back to the spinning toe hold on the other grappler. And in very short order, we have seen Ted Oates clear the ring of both grappler number one and grappler number two. Grappler number one now, the legal man in the ring and against Ted Oates. Of course, a little bit later this hour, we'll get a chance to see Wildfire Tommy Rich. And I understand from NWA President Bob Geigel that Tommy Rich is among the stars that will be on hand for that one-night tag team tournament to determine a new Central States Tag Team Champion. And of course, you've got to include the team of the grapplers in that list. I don't know if their application has been officially accepted by Geigel or not. And from what I've seen so far in this match, you better put Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates in there too. Ritchie caught the grappler in the corner with a right hand, but as his attention was distracted, the grappler number one came in from behind, blindsided Ritchie with a knee to the small of the back, and now starts to go to work on young Ron Ritchie. And the grapplers, especially in matches with Ron Ritchie, have gone out of their way not only to win the match, which is of course the object of any person who is involved in professional wrestling, but quite honestly, they've gone out of their way to try to injure somebody. And that's not only beyond the realm of sportsmanship, it gets down to tell you exactly what kind of guys these grapplers really are. Ritchie now caught with some high-flying hands of the grappler number two. And number two, posting the legs, bringing his man up almost like a Boston Crab and slingshotting him into the waiting elbow of his partner. And here's the thing that makes the grapplers such a great team. One grappler drawing Ted Oates into the ring. And of course, Sonny Myers has no choice but to go put Ted Oates up. This gives the grapplers a chance to double-team Ron Ritchie behind their man. And they wasted no time at all in getting on this young man. Grappler number one. Neckbreaker on Ron Ritchie. A count of two and Ritchie's out. I've been talking to Ron a couple of days ago, talking about this match with the grapplers. And Ron Ritchie's usually a pretty easygoing guy, but I have never seen him get as upset as he does, even in normal conversation, just when the subject of these grapplers come up. There's been untold incidents, and here you can see some of the reasons why this Ron Ritchie is so dead set. He seems to be making it a major point in his career to go after these grapplers. And when he asked Ted Oates to be his partner, apparently Oates has had some run-ins himself in the great state of Texas with these gentlemen. He was only more than glad to sign that contract and be a part of this tag team match. Oates now on the ring apron. Ah! Ritchie caught the grappler, but I'm not sure Ron Ritchie knows where he is right now. The tag to grappler, and yeah, he made the tag to Ted Oates, and here comes Oates. Firing away at both grapplers. Another hard right hand, Ritchie's in. He's got number two over in the corner. Leg sweep from Ted Oates. And Oates again going right into that spinning toehold on the grappler. Now Ritchie, both men going in on that spinning toehold. Look at that. Ritchie was caught as he went around on the toehold and kicked out of the ring. Ted Oates blindsided by the grapplers, and now knee lift that sends the grappler to the canvas. Oates has got grappler number one again in that spinning toehold. And wait a minute. It looks like Ted Oates may be going for the boot of the grappler. Yes, he's going for the boot of the grappler number one. Wait a minute. Here comes the grappler number two off the top. Referee Sonny Myers is calling for the bell. Jump off the top rope. What? And Ted Oates now double teamed from behind by the grapplers. Ron Ritchie back into the ring, going it alone against both of the masked grapplers. And now Oates back up on that ring apron, and we've got pandemonium at ringside. Wait a minute. The mask of the grappler number one has been torn open at the top. And Ted Oates looks like he's going for the mask. He's ripped it across the forehead. The grappler number one, his boot half off, his mask half torn away. What a match. This situation's far from over, but nevertheless, a big win for Ritchie and Ted Oates on TV. We'll be back with more. You stay with us right here on All Star Wrestling.
Great Country Wrestling, St. Louis, in the Kiel Auditorium, Friday, March 30th. What a match at 7:30 p.m. Tickets on sale now. Kiel Box Office, All Famous Bar Stores, Regal Sports, Team Togs and Tickets, dial tick 644-1700. Mail order to St. Louis Wrestling Club, Kiel Auditorium, 14th and Market Street, St. Louis. There's no service charge or call 436-4400. We talked to Wahoo McDaniel.
Gentlemen, the match is signed. It's signed for right here in St. Louis at Kiel Auditorium. Chief Wahoo McDaniel is going to wrestle Harley Race for the Missouri State title. It's a no disqualification match. And Wahoo, Bobby Heenan is Harley Race's manager.
Well, you know, Harley Race might be slipping a little bit if he needs a manager. You know, it's hard for me to believe that a man, a 6'4", weighs 290 pounds, 7, 8, 9 times the world's champion, now the Missouri heavyweight champion, would need a manager to go out and wrestle a poor little Indian boy like me, Wahoo McDaniels. That's fine, Harley. You know, I don't mind, because a man, I've got to say one thing for Harley Race. I challenged him to a strap match. He came out, he took his punishment. And he didn't like it very well either, because I tell you, I am the master of the strap match. Now, he might be the master of the no disqualification match, but Harley, I know what no disqualification means. That means anything goes. I can do anything you can do. You know, and I'm not just a real small man, you know. Played 10 years of pro football. I've been around, and I know what pain and suffering's about. Had to grow up on an Indian reservation. So I am ready. Now, I'm going after the most prestigious belt in that area, the Missouri Heavyweight Championship belt. Harley holds that belt, and I know he's going to do everything he can to keep it. Why you've got the weasel with you, I'll never know. But I want to say one thing. When I come out of that ring, a lot of people boo me, and a lot of them cheer me. Whether booing me or cheering me makes me no difference, because I'm going to have that Missouri heavyweight belt right around my waist, Harley Race, once and for all.
Does
this event is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, weighing 222 pounds, Tiger Mask. His opponent from Fort Smith, Arkansas, weighing 221 pounds, Dave Austin.
Tiger Mask squaring off against Dave Austin here on All-Star Wrestling. Austin, a native of the great state of Arkansas, has made quite a reputation for himself there. And of course, Tiger Mask in the last 6 to 10 weeks has really, really done a good job of really warping through the competition. And I see a young man here standing right next to me at ringside with a very brightly lettered sign that says Tiger Mask number one. Just kind of symbolic about the way that the fans here in the Central States area have really taken to this star. And of course, Tiger Mask has been involved with this feud ongoing between him and Roger Kirby. It seems like Kirby, in his continuing battle to unmask Tiger Mask, has gone to just about any limit to get Tiger Mask under any stipulations in the ring. He says he'll meet him anywhere, anytime. Tiger Mask is not one to back down from the challenge. He said, whatever suits Kirby suits me just fine as well. And look at that. Tiger Mask completely jumping over the top of the head of Dave Austin. Rolls his man forward from a front chancery and almost gets the pin on Dave Austin here on All-Star Wrestling. And by the way, coming up next week, we'll have another opportunity to see Ted Oates, and what a match that was. Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates, a big win by disqualification over the Grapplers. And I'll guarantee you one thing, the situation between Ron Ritchie, Ted Oates, and two masked gentlemen by the name of the Grapplers is probably long from over. And with the big issue of the Central States Tag Team Championship belts fixing to come up here in the next couple of weeks, both teams, I know, all personal issues aside, will be going at each other hammer and tongs. Now, Dave Austin set his man for a backdrop, and Tiger Mask completely somersaulted over, cut him with an arm drag, and tied up Dave Austin here on the canvas. Now, still coming up in the next couple of minutes, we'll be seeing a young man who the fans in the Central States area have been asking to see for a long time. And hats off to NWA president and promoter Bob Geigel. He has secured the contracts, and yes, Wildfire Tommy Rich is on his way to the Central States. We'll be seeing him just a little bit later this hour on All-Star Wrestling. Plus, Crazy Luke Graham in action, Bulldog Bob Brown, and many more of your favorite stars. The rest of this hour promises to be just as action-packed as the first half was. Dave Austin now catching Tiger Mask the full body slam. Austin carefully said, oh, look at that. Austin tried to set his man up for a knee drop. Tiger Mask just too quick for him. Moves in and around. It looks like almost a reverse figure four leg lock. I've never seen anything like this before. Mask arches himself back, and I don't know what you call it, but one thing is for certain, it spelled the end of day. Wait a minute. Here comes Roger Kirby. Roger Kirby, dressed in his street clothes, coming out from behind Tiger Mask, blindsided Mask while he was on the floor. And now we've got a Donnybrook going in the ring. Both men trading. And Tiger Mask, Roger Kirby, from out of nowhere. We talked about the between these two. Oh! He had to be 7 feet up in the air for that backdrop. Tiger Mask caught completely by surprise, fighting back from all he's worth against Roger Kirby. Kirby pulled into the corner post, caught with a backdrop from Tiger Mask. And we've got Bedlam here in the ring. Tiger Mask now up on that rope, pounding away at the head of Roger Kirby. And we got to get some kind of order restored here. Mask and Kirby fighting back and forth. The feud between them lives on. And Roger Kirby, I know now, being threatened with suspension by Sonny Myers. He takes, well, let's try to get some kind of order here. We'll be back. You stay with us. All-Star Wrestling will return right after these important messages.
King of Critic.
Wrestlers in the history of our sport would have to be Wildfire Tommy Rich. And of course, for a period of 3 days, Tommy Rich was the NWA World's Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. And many experts predict that one day in the future, Tommy Rich will regain that 10 pounds of gold. But nevertheless, Wildfire himself is on the way to the Central States area by request of the fans and by special arrangement of the National Wrestling Alliance. Let's go right now into the ring and see the man himself, Wildfire Tommy Rich.
One fall, 10-minute time limit. Tommy Wildfire Rich moving out against Roger Bond. This should prove to be an interesting match. Bond, a solidly built young fellow. Excellent amateur background. Caught in a side headlock into a hip lock takedown by Rich. Off the ropes, Bond drops to the canvas. Rich up and over his man. Rich caught him. Bond tried to set him up, and Rich was a step ahead. High knee lift puts Bond back to the canvas again. Rich swoops around his man. Rear chin lock now by Tommy Rich. Nice to have Cheryl Thompson here from Columbus, Ohio. Folks up around Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, been having a lot of heavy snow. Tommy Rich, who may have made one of the most eventful decisions of his life recently. Moving well now against Roger Bond. And I'll tell you what, if Rich has to, he can take those shortcuts as well as anybody. He can fierce six it if you want to, or he can go by the rules and regulations if you prefer. But he has really made a very, very important, critical decision in his lifetime. And it's Rich continuing to keep that rear chin lock on Bond. Now, Bond is a young man that... barring injuries along the way, I think has got a very promising future.
I think you're right there, Gordon. As we said before, if he gets the wrong people and gets destroyed at an early time, then it will probably have an adverse effect on his career. I wanted to make a comment. Somebody just hit me again in the back, and they were talking about Paul Ellering. We've already been after Ellering. The interference that he... had here on the match a few moments ago with the extremely important match between Snake Roberts and Ronnie Garvin. Ellering claims that he just brushed the feet and was trying to push Ronnie Garvin's feet back into the ring. You know, when it gets to a position like that, I know sometimes it's very difficult to understand, and it's hard for me to understand too, and I know for you. But you've got to try to look at it, let's say, from the standpoint, at least the referee. He's one man in that ring. He's doing the best job that he possibly can. There's no way that he can have eyes in the back of his head. When a decision is made by the referee, he can show all the film you want. And you can have everybody say what they want to say. The decision is still referees at that point, like it is in any other sport, whether it's football or basketball or baseball.
I was just going to say, look at the touchdowns this year that were scored and weren't scored.
Yeah.
And it showed it back on TV.
Sure. And so sometimes you feel like you've been... well, had in so many words, but it's not something to be taken out of the referee. In this case, you talk to Ellering like I just did, and boy, it's a pleasure for me to be able to see a guy like that. I wish I had my tights on. He even looks at me and says, well, why the heck don't you see what you can do with the Sheik? He's talking about the crazy man that he's brought in, or he gives me that, why don't you go after the Road Warriors instead of trying to pick on me? Well, Ellering, there's a lot of people, one in particular that I can think of, that's after you now, and there's a lot of guys after your Road Warriors, and we've got some big ones for a change, and we've got some good people going after Snake. So I think, at least I hope, maybe the Christmas present's going to come for all of us, holiday or whatever, where we might see some belts changing hands and maybe see an end to Paul Ellering.
84 might be an entirely different year for Mr. Paul Ellering. Right now it's Tommy Wildfire Rich keeping the rear chin lock on Bond, and Bond makes it to the ropes, and that forces the break. Bond shows
A lot of good common strategy, good common sense out there in the ring, even though he is a relative newcomer to the ranks of pro wrestling. Caught with a drop toe hold that time and a quick float up by Tommy Wildfire Rich, and it looks like he's got a partial front chancery on him. But Bond is a clever competitor. I think I have a lot of respect for this young man.
You know something else, guy just over here in the camera reminded me. We may be, and I certainly hope that's not the case. But you have to think about the seriousness of the challenge that's been issued, the contract that's been signed. It could very well be the last time that you'll be seeing Tommy Rich.
Yes, that's the very thing we've been talking about earlier, is that Tommy Rich's career may be over very, very shortly. And what a tragic situation. However, Rich is the kind of an athlete that could be very, very adept in any sport. But it is Bond now punishing him, getting the side headlock as he did. Rich took him with a belly-to-back suplé. And so Bond is stunned. And Rich, perhaps losing his temper just a little bit here, punishing Bond slightly, then brings him back to the canvas with another snap mare and back into a rear chin lock. So Rich seems intent upon wearing his man down. And I think Rich, possibly because of the things that he has facing him in the near future, I think Rich is trying to get just every bit that he can out of this man to get a real test.
Well, at the moment, he's combining a lot of things that he knows in professional wrestling. He's in there doing a little bit of brawling, and of course, he's doing a lot of good wrestling. He's now concentrating on a hold. He knows that he's got his whole life before him. I don't think there's any question about that. I know how serious it is, and I'm sure he does too. And I think that everybody should, if they could for a moment, put themselves in a position where this one decision could cost everything. It's very, very seldom in a man's life that he makes that kind of a decision to put himself in a position where everything is going to be determined by one match or one game or whatever it might be. And yet Tommy has done just that. He's going to have to be a very determined man in order to see this thing through.
No question about it. Rich just caught him with a good drop kick coming off the ropes. Rich is up. Caught him in a sleeper. Caught him in a sleeper coming off the ropes. Tommy Wildfire Rich closing in with a sleeper, and we haven't seen him use that sleeper in a long time. And he's a master at it. And Bond slowly sinking into oblivion. It's over. It is over. Roger Bond is out. Tommy Wildfire Rich is the victor.
Five wrestlers to see action on Friday night, March 30th at 7:30 p.m. You'll find tickets on sale now at the Kiel Box Office, All Famous Bar Stores, Regal Sports, Team Togs, and Tickets. Dial Tix at 644-1700, or you can mail order to St. Louis Wrestling Club, Kiel Auditorium, 14th Market Street, St. Louis, Missouri, and there's no service charge. Or telephone 436-4400, but don't fail to get your tickets for this event. Also, Salem, Illinois. Look out for wrestling action on Saturday, March 31st, 7:30 in the high school gym. Now, here's the card you're going to see. For the Missouri title and no disqualification rule, I got to talk to you about this, Harley. Harley Race, managed by Bobby Heenan, against Wahoo McDaniel. You'll see a six-man tag team match. Blackjack Mulligan, Blackjack Lanza, and Bruce Reed against Crusher Blackwell, Ken Patera, and Luke Graham. Then Jim Garvin with Precious goes against Chris Adams. Then Hacksaw Dugan and One Man Gang. That should be a real battle. Dick the Bruiser, Cy Jurgensen, Dick Slater, and Buzz Tyler. More tag teams coming up. Steve Kern and Stan Lane against Don White and T.G. Stone. And then Ted Oates and Les Thornton go against the Grapplers. Now, Harley, you got to tell me, why would you put the Missouri title up and the no disqualification rule in?
Let me tell you and the people of St. Louis, I'm tired of being intimidated and insulted by Wahoo McDaniels. He strapped me and beat me like you would a dog, buddy, like you would a dog. To get him the way I wanted him. And please believe me, Wahoo, you'll be taken care of. I got Bobby Heenan who's going to be standing out there. There's going to be no more of this hanky-panky, you using whatever you want to use, busting my head into a ring pole or doing whatever you want to do. This one's coming down to where the man in wrestling is coming out. And I have been the dominant figure in St. Louis for more years than I care to remember. Wahoo, you're a beaten man.
Thank you.
event is one full television time remaining. Introducing from Winnipeg, Canada, weighing 254 pounds, Bulldog Bob Brown. His opponent from New York, New York, weighing 302 pounds, Crazy Luke Graham.
And our TV main event, the legend himself, Bulldog Bob Brown, taking on Crazy Luke Graham, two of the top stars now in the Central States. And I tell you, the action has been hot and heavy all over the Midwest in the last couple of months, all around in great towns like Junction City, in Fort Riley, Kansas, on down into Kirksville, Missouri, of course, in the great city of St. Louis. You see the top stars in the world, record crowds everywhere that All-Star Wrestling is. And hey, when you see All-Star Wrestling on the banner, you're guaranteed the finest wrestlers in the world and some of the greatest, most exciting matches possible. Anytime you see All-Star Wrestling in your town. Luke Graham and Bob Brown had a bit of an altercation before the start of this match. Brown attacked Graham on the floor, and here's a guy that can go any way you want to go. Bulldog has got the reputation of a brawler. At various times, he's been loved and hated by wrestling fans all over the world. But there's one thing for sure. If you get in a fight in a dark alley, you want to have somebody like Bulldog Bob Brown at your side. Next week here on All-Star Wrestling, what a tremendous hour we've got in store for you. We'll be seeing stars like Wildfire Tommy, Rich, and many, many more. Crazy Luke Graham now with the advantage on Bulldog Bob Brown. With that full Nelson bringing the pressure again. We've talked about it so many times before, and you can see Bulldog, the furious effect that this is having on him, going again for that neck that, of course, was injured several months ago. Bob Brown, of course, is completely healed, but after an injury like that, of course, the psychological effects have to linger on. Brown and Graham now, and it looks like Luke Graham may have bitten Bob Brown on the arm. I don't know. Crazy Luke Graham and Bulldog Bob Brown squaring off against each other. Now we're going to have to go to a commercial break right here. However, we'll keep the cameras rolling. And should a fall occur, we'll show it to you on instant replay. You stand by. There's more great action to come on All-Star Wrestling. Onslaught on the Bulldog, using every means at his advantage, most of them pretty illegal, to get the advantage on this native of Winnipeg, Canada. And referee Sonny Myers has had his hands full trying to restore some kind of order in the ring. It seems to me that in the last 4 to 5 weeks, sheer pandemonium has been reigning in the Central States area. And with the quality and caliber of competition that we've got on the way and already here, small wonder. Now, we've seen stars over the past couple of weeks like the modern-day warrior Kerry Von Erich. We've seen a little bit earlier this hour Tommy Rich. And the situation that continues to evolve between the new team of Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates and the team of the Masked Grapplers. And if you think back just a couple of minutes to that match, you can see that the Grapplers do not have an easy road ahead of them here in the Central States area. And I think that Ron Ritchie and Ted Oates just may be the combination it takes to do a little damage to these Grapplers. Bulldog Bob Brown now at the disadvantage. Crazy Luke Graham with the Cobra hold on Brown. Apparently, he didn't have it quite where he wanted it. Bulldog was able to slip away as he went down to the canvas. And again, Luke Graham cinches down with that Cobra hold across the carotid artery of Bulldog Bob Brown. And this hold, of course, works very much like the sleeper does, blocking off the flow of the blood to the brain and eventually rendering the man it's applied on unconscious in the ring. I'm looking forward to next week on All-Star Wrestling, because we will be seeing in action, in person, Competing in our arena, Wildfire himself, Tommy Rich, the former world's champion, plus the return of Ted Oates and many, many more of your favorite stars. So wherever you're watching this show, whether it be in Des Moines, Iowa, or St. Louis, Topeka, or Pittsburgh, you make your plans to join us next week right here on All-Star Wrestling. You'll be guaranteed some of the most exciting action anywhere around when you tune into All-Star Wrestling. Luke Graham now continuing to apply that cobra hold on Bulldog Bob Brown. And it looked like Bob Brown was going to make his way out of this, but crazy Luke Graham kept on. We're fast running out of time here on All-Star Wrestling. We'll stay with this match just as long as we can. Luke Graham continuing his advantage, and the battle between these two is far from over. Bulldog Bob Brown and crazy Luke Graham. We'll see you next week. This is Ric Stuart. Be looking for you on All Star Wrestling.
Stay right where you are. There's more professional wrestling action coming your way next here on Channel 30.